season and a lot of success and some definitely some disappointments as well. So I think that for our team and our players, they definitely learned from that and grew from it. So yeah, I think we are probably ahead of where we were a year ago. You know, I have a year under my belt. They know me a little bit more. I know them, and you know, our coaching staff is here and kind of in place. So it's been nice. You know, it's nice to do a lot of refreshing as opposed to teaching from the bottom up. Of course, we still have to do that a little bit with our new kids, but our returners have done a lot of that too. So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's nice. I mean, everyone came in this season in really good shape, so that was really nice to see. We do have a lot of people coming back, but I think it would be a mistake to assume that just because we have a lot coming back and kind of that core, that it's the same team as last year and the same thing is going to happen as last year. I mean, we don't get any sort of advantage for winning last year. We don't start the game like 10 points ahead or anything. The other teams don't care about that. So our mindset has just been, you know, getting better every single day. And we do have the advantage of we do get to build off what we did last year in practice because the few new players that we do have were here this summer, so they kind of got to learn that stuff. So it's definitely been like a really great first few weeks of practice.
So like just to like elaborate off of what Bree said, like I think we're coming together well, but we can't like, you know, we can't really say that we have the same team as last year. Like, you know, we have different people on the team now, so it's important for us to keep like growing as a team, individually and together for each step.
We do, we have a great group of kids, you know, and I said after last year, if every year was like that, I would coach until I died. You know, I mean, it's just, they're fantastic. They trust what you say. They work hard every day. They do what they're supposed to do. You know, there's no drama. There's no, you know, wondering if they're going to class, or they're good kids and they do it the right way. And so that's great. And then, you know, as far as playing, you know, they want to learn. They want to be the best. They want to get better. And so coaching them is fun. They're all really coachable. And it doesn't just happen overnight, you know, it's something that's been building since, you know, we got here with Coach Barron 8 years ago, you know, but they've really grasped that and have high expectations of each other as well, you know, and so when you have that, you know, playing basketball is fun, you know, they love each other, they love playing together, they love to make the extra pass. You know, it's not about them, it's about each other. And so when you have a group like that, a lot of really good things can happen. So.
I mean, I guess you could say it's different because like we're like the one that everyone wants to play now. But from like me, and I think like from everyone else, is like the same for us. You know what I mean? Like our mentality hasn't changed. We know for sure that we have to like go out and do what we have to do, like day in and practice. And let it carry on to the game. But I do think it brings like excitement as far as being the team that everyone's looking forward to play.
Yeah, I think it's fun. It's definitely different from last year where, you know, people didn't really know what to expect from us. I think having that target on our back kind of forces us to raise our level of play because we know that teams are gonna give us their best shot, so we need to be ready for that every single night.
I mean, it's one of those things where we have to work on it every single day, you know. You know, one of the things we've been talking about the last few days is, you know, if you want to do really great things, it's really, really hard, you know. And so we want to be great. We have to bring our greatness, our best every single day, you know, and we can't take days off. And so if we do that, I think we have a chance to be a really special team. And I think the kids want to do that. You know, we have two great seniors, graduate students, Paris and Tanisha, who have been through a lot in their careers, and they're ready to really lead this team. And we have juniors. I mean, Blanca and Fani have been starting since freshman year, you know, so they're only juniors in a way, but they have a lot of experience. So for us, it's taking it day by day, and you know, hopefully if we do that, we'll see success. And, you know, yeah, I mean, I think we would love to get a higher seed in the NCAA tournament, win the American East Championship first, get a higher seed in the NCAA tournament, and win a game. You know, I mean, it's been a long time since 1999. It's been a really long time, so it would be great. Now, that's a long way away. It's October. That's in March. So we can't think of that. We just got to take it one day at a time. But yeah, that would be fantastic.
I mean, I think it can't be understated how important our crowd is to our success. They really are like a sixth man to us. They've been following us, you know, for a long time throughout this whole building process. And other teams notice it too. In the championship game, I was guarding someone and she literally made a comment like, "Your fans are incredible." So when other teams notice that, it makes a huge difference. It's it helps our momentum and just it really gives us something else to play for, and it's huge.
Yeah, it's really exciting to have like so many fans there who's like willing to like, you know, cheer us on like no matter what, like, and like especially like I feel like it's important too, like when we go and shake their hands and stuff, like just having a little brief conversation before a game, it's like, you know, you really get to see that they really there and supporting us. And like Bree said, like I'm pretty sure our fans, I mean like our opponents are like wow, this is like a big like a big stage to play on, like with the fans in the background screaming, yelling. So it's pretty good to play in front of them.
Our fans are amazing, you know, and they're there, win or lose, they're there. But we have been fortunate at the Cross Center. It's a fantastic atmosphere. You know, they encourage us. You know, we win the championship because it's at the Cross Center last year. You know, I mean, I still have people that talk to me when I see them about that atmosphere and about that game and how special it was. And so our kids love playing there. We love our fans. We wouldn't take anyone else, you know, and you're right. You know, when other teams come to the Cross Center, they're amazed, you know, amazed. And, you know, not their words are not everyone gets this following, you know, so it's a really special place.